News Jax is helping you understand the amendments you'll be deciding on in the midterm elections.
New at 5:30, Action News Jax Courtney Cole breaks down a proposal to restore voting rights to most felons.
Amendment number 4 is one of the more discussed amendments that you'll see on your ballot in November. It's going to give you the ability to decide if people with prior felony convictions should be able to vote once they finish their sentences. You've seen the ad on TV. A man is released from prison, rejoins his family, but faces barriers to his return to a normal life. Along with trouble finding a job, he's lost the right to vote. Right now, at least 1.5 million felons have not regained the right to vote in the state of Florida. Wade Cooper told Action News Jax he knows what it's like to be one of those millions.
In 1999, I had a charge of counterfeit money. So, it was a situation where just me being, you know, stupid, you know, dumb at the time.
19 years later, he's the co-owner of a local clothing boutique and also works at a local bail bonds. But even with those accomplishments, one of the things he's most proud of is getting his voting rights back.
It was a long process. They tell you, you call on the phone, the waiting time to even speak to somebody is a long time, but you have to be patient.
In Florida, if you have a felony conviction, you have to wait at least 5 years before you can apply to the governor for clemency, and it's not guaranteed. The clemency board currently has a backlog of more than 10,000 cases, and on average, it restores the voting rights of a few hundred a year. Now, here's how voting restoration rights are being treated in the rest of the nation. In 22 states, felons lose their rights until they complete their sentence. In 14 states, and the nation's capital, felons only lose their rights while they're incarcerated. In Maine and Vermont, felons never lose their rights.
Now, the amendment would not automatically restore the voting rights of those convicted of murder or sexual offenses. Those individuals would still need to apply to the state clemency board. Courtney Cole, CBS 47, Action News Jax.